Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let me show you how to password protect and encrypt documents. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 900 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There, you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So I'm often asked how you can password protect a document on your Mac. So I'm going to show you a few methods. But first, let me tell you why it's probably not necessary. Everybody that uses a Mac should have their own user account and should have it password protected. You should be the only one that has the password to your account. Now, as long as you have that set up and you don't leave it unlocked lying around for other people to access, then all of your files are really password protected. Nobody can get into your account, so nobody can see any of your files. And if you have File Vault turned on, then everything's encrypted. So even if somebody steals your computer, they still can't get into those files no matter what they do. So in most cases, when people ask me about password protecting or encrypting a document, it's really not necessary. But there are a few situations that do occasionally come up. For instance, you may not own your Mac. It may be a company Mac. Other people may actually have access to it. You may want to protect a file from anybody else that wants to look. For instance, you may store a file with some notes for a future job search, and you want to make sure that your boss can't see that. Sometimes we also put files in public places, like you may have a company or school web server where you can put a file and it's kind of out of your control. Maybe other people can easily see it, or maybe it's a little more difficult, but you want to make sure that if somebody does have access to it, they can't open it without a password. Another reason you may want to password protect a document is when sending it to somebody else over email. Email technically really isn't that secure. So if you have to send something that's very sensitive, you may want to password protect the document. Of course, in that case, you don't want to include the password in the email that also has the document as an attachment. So you want to talk to the person on the phone, or maybe send them a message some other way with the password. Another reason is you may want to give a document to somebody, but not let them have access to it right away. In other words, give somebody a document with emergency instructions, but only give them the password if that emergency occurs. Or maybe give students a quiz and then another document with the answers, but don't give them the password to the answers right away. And then, of course, there are those people that just want to have a double layer of security. They just will sleep a little bit better at night knowing that some sensitive information is not only stored behind a password wall in their account, but also somebody needs a different password to actually open that document. All right, so how do you password protect a document? Well, let's start with Pages, Numbers, and Keynote, the primary document creation apps on your Mac. It's really easy to do this in these apps. So here I've got a Pages document, and if I go to File, there's Set Password. I just use that and set a password. You can put a password hint for yourself if you want. And you can also say, remember this password in my keychain, meaning that the document can be easily opened up on your Mac. But if you put it somewhere else or share it with somebody else, they're not going to have access to your keychain, so they'll need a password. This is a great option because it means you're not really inconvenienced by the password, but other people need it to get access to the document in other locations. And then when you set the password, now if you close the document and then try to open it again, it asks for the password. And now the document's open and you can use it as a normal document until you close it again. Once a password is set, you can go back here and it's Change Password Now, and you have to enter the old password and then a new password and verify, or you can use this button here to remove the password. So you can temporarily password protect a document and then remove the password later. Now in Numbers and Keynote, they work the same way. Go to File and you have Set Password, and it's exactly the same options. And here it is in Keynote. Now other apps may or may not offer this option and may put it in a different place. So for instance, Microsoft Word certainly does offer this. You have to go to Tools, and then down here you've got Protect Document. But that's not the only way to password protect a document. You could also create a PDF from just about any app and assign a password to it. So you couldn't put some sensitive information, say in a Pages document that you have, create a PDF, and the PDF requires a password, and that's the one that you share with somebody else over email or on a shared server, something like that. So here in Pages, if I want to produce a PDF, I could do it one of two ways. One is I could go to File, Export to, PDF. And then in here, I can select Require Password Open. And here I can set a password, verify it, and include a hint. And then I'll save the PDF. So I'll save this here to the desktop. And now you can even see the PDF has a little lock there. It of course won't show you a preview of what's in the PDF in the icon because it's password protected. If I try to open it up, it tries to open it in preview and it prompts me to enter the password first before I get access to the information. Now the other way to create a PDF in Pages and just about any app is to go to File and then Print. As long as you can print, you can usually get to a PDF menu here and you could save as PDF. One of the options you've got then is Security Options here. Click that and you can require a password to open the document. You could also require the password to copy text and to print. Now what's great about that is you could take apps that don't have any password protection option and still create password protected PDFs from them. So for instance, TextEdit, I could go in here and say print. I could go to PDF, save as PDF, and I've got those same security options here. You can do that from anything. So for instance, you could be on a private web server that people normally don't have access to. And if you want to share some information there, you could go and print the web page that you're looking at and then choose save as PDF and then assign a password to that PDF. So now you can share it to somebody else who may not have access to that website, but they still need a password just to see the information in the PDF. Now one other note, there is a difference between password protecting a document and encrypting it, but not in this case. In this case, everything I'm showing you actually encrypts the document. Password protection without encryption really isn't worth anything. If somebody could actually look at the bits in the file and see what's in there, then the password protection isn't any kind of real security. So when you password protect a document in Pages, Numbers, Keynote, Word, or you password protect a PDF, you're actually encrypting it and adding a password that's the key to decrypting it. The differences between password protecting a document like Pages, Numbers, Keynote, or Word and password protecting a PDF is PDF by its nature is kind of the finished document. You're not going to be editing a PDF, whereas you will be editing those other file types. So if it's something you need to update all the time or collaborate with somebody else on, then you want to password protect the actual document so that you can continue to work on it and update it. But if it's a document with finished information, then create a password protected PDF. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.